Chrysler people were only too happy to sell industrial engines. They had hard drive parked out. They did a lot of applications. They just go after this well.
No, I'm gonna leave it on here for 44 and a half, but that one's got the four cylinder in it. And the 44, kind of a comparable size to the A and the...
Massey had good stuff, good ideas, but somebody had to fall by the wayside, and a lot of them did.
And here's the 101 Junior. They had a 101 Junior, then they had a 101 Senior, too, and they just kind of did a few minor things just to make some of the difference in. But like you said, they, you know, as time evolved, they got ate up by other manufacturers.
There's the co-op, 1951-83, as well as Solutions Command as well. As I mentioned earlier, co-op came out of Bradford, Ontario, was in the wheat growing country. They made initially and then worked in the tractors of their own. And good stuff.
Yeah, they're from Roy Collection, also a 101 Senior. You had your junior and you had your senior. And they just kind of, you know, just did some minor things to update them, get them a little more involved, maybe different features or two.
This Johansson tractor is on propane. This little girl would not run too long between drinks if you were out bothering her. You'd best be close to the tank or have the tank close to you. That's a big tractor, 1962-97, Massey Ferguson, also called.
It's nice that Lewis has been able to hold on to that and keep it in the family, but it's kind of fun to see that.
We got a little, this from Dale Wright Company, that's line South Dakota, little 59-530 again, and so your basic 530. The seating gradually got better on tractors as they went along, you know, that's a little better than what we have on the 8 behind it.
1952 H Paul on Charlie Shirt from straight run, a straight mile, a straight run of the H.
This comes from Sioux Falls, South Dakota, Desert Johnson. The little tractor, this is an example of an unstyled tractor. This is 1938 B John Deere. It has 4 speeds. You swing one lever to the side to get into two of the high ones, then to go the other way, you just do low ones in reverse. Just your basic little John Deere. But it was before they started and closed the market.
1954-60 John Deere Cat Run, that's from Brookings, South Dakota. It looked like a truck restoration with a factory white front on it, which you just don't find every day.
Seal on the rear end from Ted Reese went out of Brookings, South Dakota. You can imagine how tough a ride that would be all day long if you were following stubble or something like that. In addition to having the dirt come up after you, just the inconvenience of it all.
1940 Marvin, Michaela Reflin from Brookings, South Dakota.
That was as far as you could get with a two-cylinder tractor. They had used up the ability to make power on them.
47H John Deere, Eric, as Mike said, the smallest of the two-cylinder horizontal engines, and two things there, but the smallest tractor, plus the belt pulley on that runs the opposite way of its bigger brother, so that runs off the cam more so than the crank like the little one, too.
Got a 41B down here. This is what I got last year when we started on gas and switched over, and he kept it at about 190-200 degrees, and he could burn furnace oil in. 41 blocks, quite hard on that.
In the 1937 Model 8 down here from Madison, South Dakota, and they're looking they were very popular tractor in their day at 37. It was a good year, and then 10-36-37. They were pretty plentiful, and they did a lot of work for that air tractor.
So 37 WC. We've seen a few WCs come through today. This one belongs to Gene Graham out of Sioux Falls. What's neat about this, he was driving this tractor with World War II engine August 6, 1944. None of us have had the distinction of going through something like that.
Between that and the H's, this mortar is vertical. It's a dual two-cylinder mortar, but it runs up and down, or the H runs horizontal. But that is the baby. That is the smallest down here of the main.
We got it.
It's left alone. And just leave it in everyday workflows. Is the kind of way a lot of us remember.
And a lot of them. We didn't have drives. What if they didn't live in the jeep shed?
No, like they do now. They just sat under a tree or a finer canvas.
Yeah, that was the jeep shed. The AR is from 1952. The AR belongs to Bruce and Deborah and Lon Sinball. This is fairly just
the 39F20 from Tim O'Connell from Madison, South Dakota.